Today, I'm testing your awareness. There will be two questions at the end. One is related to what you're going to see on today's video, and the other one, you're going to have to test it by yourself and come back with the answer. There will be 10 battle passes giveaway. If you answer correctly to both questions, I will personally reach out to you in the comments and ask for your UID. I'll send you a friend request and will give you the reward. 10 of you will be selected after 1 week. Let's begin. But first, a huge thank you to Ace Force 2 for sponsoring today's video. Ace Force 2 is a Valorant-like game, a 5v5 hero-based tactical mobile shooter game developed by Tencent's Morfun Studios. Powered by Unreal Engine 4, Ace Force 2 offers exhilarating tactical combat experiences.
See that? Piece of cake!
Players can enjoy the game for free, engaging in fair competition through virtual shooting battles.
Okay, mission accomplished!
No!
With virtual characters and a variety of abilities and weapons, players can adapt to the battlefield, using precise shooting and versatile abilities to strive for victory for the team, experiencing thrilling and enjoyable team-based confrontations. Attention to all our Mexican players. Currently, Ace Force 2 is not available in Google Play in Mexico. But don't worry, you can still enjoy Ace Force 2 by downloading the APK on the official site. If you still cannot download it from the official site, you can directly click the APK link from the description to download it. But my question is, what are you waiting for? Download the game from the description and show the world your elegant combat techniques. One thing is clear. They started engaging me since the beginning of the video. The other thing that is clear to me is that they want the gunsmith. I want to rush them, but at the same time, I don't want them to know that. So I brought the chopper as high as I could on top of Sakura and jumped on the nearest house to the gunsmith for a surprise attack. And oh boy, surprise attack it was. The only problem I have now is a new squad coming in.
Airdrop has been delivered.
And bear in mind, this are not some headless chicken mambo jambo squads. Are highly trained individuals playing together and holding hands like they're all married to each other. This is the right way to play. They don't leave many gaps for mistakes. 3 coming in, I have to retreat. Of course, what would be a BR match without a mechanic lover? In it? That's why I love SMGs over shotguns. With shotguns, you have 50% chances or less to one-tap someone, even if your accuracy is on point. With SMG is a different story. There's someone sneaking behind my back.
Safe zone is collapsing. Airdrop incoming. Airdrop has been delivered.
The safe zone is collapsing and is hitting hard. I want to make sure they don't take any vehicles and drive into the safe zone. And I don't mind at all if they have to die to the zone either.
The last revive flight will arrive in 1 minute.
You see, here is the difference in mentality. One guy driving around on an ATV. I can't be bothered with that since most of the bullets don't register anyway. But my other enemy made that ATV his main priority. Not me, not the safe zone, not the dog tags, but the ATV. Am I going to kill him? For sure. Is the safe zone going to kill him? For sure. Is the guy on the ATV going to kill him? Less probably, even if he gets hit by that vehicle. So please make your priorities straight in difficult situations like this. Most of the times when someone drives blindly towards some crates, and on top of that, outside the safe zone, is just going to collect tags, meanwhile praying to God to not get killed. Looks like my other enemy did a pretty good job shooting this ATV. Might as well try my luck and get this job done. But if that ain't gonna work, I'm not trying a second time. That worked perfectly. And to whoever you are outside the safe zone, thanks for risking your life to give me a free kill. That dude on the vehicle must be him. God damn it. Hey, quick question. What do you call a season 1 ghost with green backpack that slides to the right and shoots you in the head?
A cricket?
Nope. Try again.
Okay, let me see.
Too late. It's called Narco.
Evin içinde saklanıyor. Aman, aman, aman.
Hey, quick question. What's called a season 1 ghost that... never mind.
Airdrop incoming.
Mehmet abi, bu sadece bir oyun. Manyaklar birbirleriyle...
The old sliding around the corner trick. It makes you question your whole life sometimes. I don't really like where the safe zone is ending. Too much open space. Sat and thought to myself, would have been any better if I left the other player alive to help me fight this squad, Yes, but I didn't knew if he was alone either to begin with. Would have been any better if I was taking cover behind the airdrop. Less probably. Is too small. Would have been any better if I had thrown a smoke grenade? Not really. One of the players was a smoke bomber user. Would have been any better if I had jumped on the snowboard and look around for another cover? Definitely, if there was any cover at all. But on that safe zone was no such cover, and if I was just sliding around on that snowboard, I would have probably been dead in no time. Sometimes you just have to work with what you have. And if you have nothing, pray that your enemies are not holding hands. The first question. What are your main priorities if you're outside the safe zone is collapsing, and on top of that, you have me around, knowing that you're outside the safe zone? Should you worry about people driving around for the dog tags, or you should worry about me and the safe zone? And the second question is, how much HP is left on your helicopter if it gets hit by an FHJ at 100% HP? Knowing the answer to this question will save your life many, many times. I'm just sad to blow up choppers with low HP on a daily basis. So, answer to both questions correctly, and don't forget to come back in exact 7 days to check on your comment and see if you are one of the winners. Good luck to everyone, and see you around.